to e-design and craft tutorials. Today I'll be teaching you to make a pouch. It's a handbag but it's in form of a pouch. It's very fashionable. You can use it with any kind of dress. What we'll need for this pouch is we'll need fabric, we'll need wadding, and we'll need lining, and then zipper. That's all. So the measurement, the bag, the pouch is going to have a front and a back, front and back. It's going to have a top where the zipper will enter. It's going to look like this. It's going to have a front and back, the top where the zipper is going to enter, and the bottom to complete it. So the bag basically has four parts. The measurement for the front and the back, I measured 11.5 inches by 11.5 inches. The length 11.5 inches, the width 11.5 inches. But I needed this part to be cuffed like a school bag. So what I did was, assuming this is what was, this is the original part. Assuming it was still a square, because I measured a square. What I did was, I measured 1.5 inches in, 2.5 inches this way, 2.5 inches this way, and then I connected the points. I did the same for this side. This is what, that is how I got this piece. I measured 1.5 inches in diagonally, then I marked. I measured 2.5 inches from here, I marked. I measured 2.5 inches from here, I marked, and then I joined the point. I did for the two sides. That's how I got this. So the measurement for the front and the back is 11.5 inches by 11.5 inches. By 10.5 inches, sorry. 11.5 inches by 10.5 inches. And then the next thing I did was, this is my zipper. The length of my zipper is, 18.5 inches. 18.5 inches. I cut this other material to be 3 inches, two of them. They are going to be on the two sides. I'm going to sew the zip on the two sides. I'm going to sew the zip, put the zip here, and then fix the zip here. The zip is going to be in between these two materials. This will form the top of my bag. The zip will be in between these two materials, and it will form the top of my bag, the top to halfway down the sides. So the length of this material is the exact length of my zip. The exact length of my zip, I measured it. While the width is 3 inches. By the time I join the zip, 0.5 inches will be out, leaving me with about 2 inches here and 2 inches here. So everything, the whole length of this place, sorry, by the time I take out 0.5 inches from each side to sew my, as my seam allowance for the zip, what will be left here will be 2.5 inches, 2.5 inches, making the whole of this width 5 inches. This is the part that will complete the bottom. How did I get this part? I measured round, 1 of this partition for the back or for the front, you pick anyone. I measured round and round. I got 40. I measured around the circumference of this back. I got 40 inches. I now came here. My zip, the length of my zip is 18.5 inches. Okay. I now assume that the length is 17.5 inches, leaving 1 inch as my sewing allowance. I assume that my zip is 17 inches, 17 and a half. You give me 22 and a half. So I come here. And I measure 22 and a half inches. And I add 1 inch sewing allowance, making it 23 and a half inches. So by the this 23 and a half inches is the part that will complete the bottom and part of the sides to make my bag. I hope you understand. Okay, welcome back. So the next thing we'll do is we'll start sewing the part of the bag since it is in parts. So the first thing you do is this material that is the exact length of the zipper, you know, I cut two of them. That's going to be the part that will join the zipper and the top of the bag. So I'll place my zipper, the top facing down on the fabric. Sorry, after cutting, I gummed my wording to all the materials. I gummed my wording to it to make it firm. So I'll keep my zipper the right side facing the material, and then I'll place my lining on top, and then I'll sew. After sewing, I'll turn the lining inside, and then I'll have something like this. The lining is going to be inside here. So we're going to have the zipper in between this material and the lining. The zipper is going to in between. So I'm going to do that, and I'll come back to show you what it looks like. So I finished sewing one side. You can see the zipper is in between the lining and the main material. So it's going to be like this. The lining is going to be under to cover the breast part. So you can see what it looks like. So I'm going to go and do the same thing for this side, and I'll come back to show you what it looks like. Okay, welcome back. So I finished fixing the zipper to this place. After fixing the zipper, I turned it, and then I sewed on top to hold it very well. I sewed on top about less than a quarter of an inch or so. And then I now sewed the sides to hold the lining together. This is what the bag looks like. So the next thing I will do now is I will place this second part that will make the under and the remaining stand to complete the sides of the bag. I'm going to place it here, and I'm going to sew half. Remember, I added 1 inch sewing allowance, so I'm going to sew out half inch here, and I'm going to join this part too, and I'm going to sew out half inch here. I'll do that, and I'll come back to show you what next to do. Welcome back. So I finished joining the top part to the bottom part, as you can see. So the next thing I'll do now is I'll locate the center. And I'm going to notch. I also locate the center of the bottom, and I'm going to notch also. I'm going to do so for the two sides. I've notched for the two sides. I've also notched the top and bottom of this part that is going to form the back and the front. So what I'll do now is I'm going to start joining. I'm going to fix this point that I notched the top of this to the top of this, and I'll start joining. I'm going to join and join and join and join and join. I'm going to join all around. I'll do that, and I'll come back to show you what I have. Sorry, I forgot to tell you. I'm going to sew sew a lining to cover this bottom part. I'm going to sew a lining. So to sew the lining, what I'll do is I'll place my lining. I'm using this Ankara as my lining. I'll place my lining on this part that has the zip. I'll place it on top, and I'll sew. And I'll also sew this other part. After sewing, I'll turn. I'll do that briefly and come back to show. Okay, so I've covered every part of this part of the bag with lining. So the wording is not showing anywhere. So the next thing I'll do is, I'll do what I said. I'm going to, I've located the center already. So at that center point, where is it? Okay, at this center point, I'm going to place the center of this front to the center of this one. And then I'll just follow the line and just sew and sew and sew round. I'll do that and come back to show you. Welcome back. So I finished sewing the front part and the back part. As you can see, I finished sewing it. But before you sew the back, maybe if you started from the front, before you sew the back, ensure you open your zipper. If you don't open your zipper, it's going to be difficult for you to turn around when you're done. So the next thing I'll do now, I've cut my lining. My lining is the size of this part. So I'm going to join my lining now. I'm going to join it. I'm going to join my lining. I'll join it. And then I'll keep a space. I'll keep a hole. Maybe about 4 inches. Where I'll turn over. I'll fix the lining for this side. And I'll also fix the lining for this side. I'm going to do that. And I'll come back to show you what I have. So I have finished sewing the lining. I've sewed and I've turned. I want to say something. When you want to, especially for those that have not sewn bags like this before, when you want to sew the lining, if you want to sew the lining for the back, you know that you're going to place your lining on the front side and then you stitch, then you turn. After turning, you want to sew for the front, you put your lining on the back and sew, then you turn it. That is how it is done. So I finished sewing, then that's just it. Come back. So I finished joining one part. I finished joining one part of the bag. So now I'm going to join the second part. I'm going to join. I'll join the front, I'll join the back now. I'll do the same thing I did. I'm going to locate the center of the top like that. I'm going to look at the center of the bottom. I've already notched it on this part, so I'll just fix it. Then I'll sew around. I'll do that and come back to show you what next to do. If you're not sure that you can sew just like that, you can pin it down. Use pin to hold it round to get the shape, then you sew. I'll do that and come back to show you. Come back. So I have finished turning my bag. I finished turning. As you can see, my bag is formed. Okay. So the next thing I will do now is to fix the handle. I have this woven strap. It's about 28 inches in length. This is a 2-inch width woven strap and it's about 28 inches in length. I have burnt this frayed edge so that the rope doesn't pull out. So what I'll do is I'm going to measure 1 inch from this joining, from here, from where I joined the bottom part to the zipper part. I'm going to measure 1 inch down. I'll locate the center and mark, and then I'm going to fold about a quarter of an inch in, and then I'm going to sew. I'm going to do that, and I'll come back to show you what it looks like. Okay, as you can see, our bag is ready. Our bag is ready. As you can see, the bag is ready. So, the method we used in making this bag, we can use the same method to make a standard school bag. It's the same method. The only difference is the size. You can also use this as a lunch box, as a lunch bag. It looks like you can use it as a lunch bag. You can use it as maybe if a bag to just throw in a few things. If you're in a hurry to maybe do a one-day trip, it can contain a few things. So that's the end of our tutorials on the making of this pouch. Thanks for watching. See you in the next class.